My name is Azim Beg and you are watching a ZTech English YouTube channel. Today we will discuss more about microwave oven. Because this is the arrangement inside the microwave oven. We'll talk about it. This transformer is definitely not for a microwave oven. I have kept this just to make you understand. Actually, it is a transformer, a capacitor, a diode and a magnetron. These four things generate microwave energy. And microwaves are responsible for heating the food inside the oven. The rest are timers and other electronic circuitry. Some of them are for safety purposes. And some are to control the heat of the food. Such as high heat for heating and intermittent low heat for defrosting. But a basic microwave oven works with only these four components. Today we will see how all these things work. And how does a magnetron generate a wave? And how does voltage doubling happen? This is a transformer. A microwave oven has a transformer. Which works in step-up mode. This is the coil we have shown, which is the secondary coil of the transformer, where 2100 volts are generated, while the primary coil is supplied with 220 volts. This is the capacitor and here we have symbolized it. And this is the diode. It has this cathode. It is grounded to the body of the microwave oven. Its lower end is attached to the capacitor. And so it is arranged. And what this diode is its cathode and the top anode, which seems to be in the capacitor. And he is attached to it. So this is the same condition as they are connected. We have this magnetron as a load. Now let's see how all these things work and how to double their voltage to near 5000 volts DC. Here we show a high tension coil, capacitor and a diode. It has a load in the form of a magnetron. Now when the first half cycle of AC occurs, which is in pulse. And its peak voltage will be 2100 or 2200 volts. At this time the top end of the coil is positive and the bottom is negative. And the current flows in the forward bias direction of the diode. This causes the capacitor to charge in pulse. And 2100 volts are present in it. Thus the first half cycle passes through the diode and charges the capacitor. And at this time no current flows through the magnetron. Now the second half cycle, which is negative. And his pack is also 2100 volts but in negative. On this we draw another circuit. When the negative half cycle occurs. So the lower end of the coil, which was negative before, has now become positive and the upper end has become negative. The direction of current flow is changed. It should be remembered that the capacitor is charged and has 2100 volts in it. 2100 volts are also present in the coil. The voltages of the coil and capacitor are adding in series according to polarity, and 2100 plus 2100 is now 4400 voltage. The diode is now in reverse bias and no current is flowing through it. Now the voltage will pass through the load. The direction of current flow will change. And the top end of the coil will now become negative and the bottom end will become positive. The diode will now be in reverse polarity and no current will flow through the diode. The maximum voltage across the coil plus the maximum voltage across the capacitor will add up, which is practically near 5000 volts. The negative 2100 voltage across the coil will accumulate the 2100 voltage across the capacitor. And negative 5000 volts will now flow through the magnetron. Now if we look at this situation carefully and try to understand it. So as you can see, only the capacitor is charging in the positive half cycle. And in the negative half cycle the magnetron is being used. We can also assume this by considering the coil as a battery. And consider the capacitor as another battery. And since these two are in series with the load. Diode in parallel with the magnetron. And its anode has negative volts and its cathode has positive volts. So no current will pass through it. In this case, a non-conducting layer is formed inside the diode. And the passage of current is obstructed. Therefore, the diode will remain in the disconnected state. And hence the voltage will only pass through the magnetron. And the heater in the middle of the magnetron is on. They will excite electrons from the heater in the magnetron in the presence of a strong magnetic field. While the number of pairs of cavities is 8. And the electrons are moving in a circle with them. Due to which vibration is being created. This vibration will result in microwave radiation. Which will be emitted by the antenna in the exhaust pipe. They will then disperse through the waveguide and cause the water molecules in the food to rub together. And the food will be hot. During this process, no waves or radiation of any kind is absorbed by the food. The process of heating food in the microwave oven is fairly simple. However, the mechanism involved in that process is somewhat atypical. After the generation of microwaves at the magnetron, they are guided by the waveguide towards the food inside the cavity. The microwaves penetrate through the surface of the food and reach the water molecules present inside it. As the orientation of the electric field changes over time, the polar molecules of water attempt to follow the field by changing their orientation inside the material to line up along the field lines in an energetically favorable configuration, namely, with the positive side pointing in the same direction as the field lines. As these molecules change direction rapidly, millions of times per second at least, they gain energy, which increases the temperature of the material. This process is called dielectric heating. The microwave energy decreases according to the inverse square law, and therefore, the cavity chamber, where we place food, is designed in such a way that it carries out the maximum efficiency of the heating effect of microwaves. Furthermore, most of the microwave ovens come with a door switch that does not allow the process to initiate until the door is completely sealed. The magnetron tube is the last vacuum tube in the world which is present in every home. Biomedical also has X-ray tube which has not yet been replaced. Hope you get some information from this video. If you like our effort, then leave a comment to let us know your valuable feedback. This will help us improve the quality of our work. See you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching the video.